Before I begin my thoughts about my dad, I want to sincerely thank everyone for taking the time out of a busy day and joining our family and putting my dad into this. Now, I was tasked with writing a eulogy for my father, a task that was easier said than done. How do I capture the essence of my father's life of almost 84 years? A 2.5-minute eulogy. How can I get people to know how loving, kind, helpful, and generous he was? How can I share with you all the sacrifices he made for the sake of his family? What stories about Roger Barredo can I tell that will show you that he was truly a good man? Now, growing back in the Philippines, I'll never forget a routine that my dad would do whenever he would get home from work that left an indelible mark in me. We normally would have dinner around 6 p.m. My mom would gather us at the dinner table, and before we would start, she'd set aside a portion of our meal for my dad, who usually gets home late from work. So picture this man coming home after a long day from work, hungry and tired. And do you know what he would do? Instead of eating right away, my dad would line up his children next to him at the dinner table and feed us one at a time before he would enjoy his dinner. To me, this action describes perfectly who my dad was. He was such a selfless man who prioritizes his family before his own needs. He worked hard to be a successful businessman in the Philippines to provide a comfortable living for his family. He gave up being his own boss to give his children an opportunity here in America. I saw my dad set aside his ego and work as a parking lot attendant, one of his first jobs in the States. I saw him wear his uniform as a parking attendant. I saw him sweep the floor of his cubicle and inhale the fumes of cars that are parking in his lot. There's nothing my dad would not do for his family. Our father was a good man. He was a wonderful, caring husband to my mother. He was a dedicated provider and protector to his children. And he was a loving grandfather to his only granddaughter. He was a supportive brother to his siblings. He was a great uncle to many of his nieces and nephews. And he was a kind human being to others. It is heartbreaking to lose our father because we want to spend more time with him. We will miss going out to dinner with him. We will miss traveling to different places with him. We will miss celebrating the holidays with our dad. We will miss going to casinos, which is something he is fond of. We will miss his guidance. We will miss his love. Rest in peace, Dad.
Really captured who my grandpa was. grandpa is one of my favorite people, and that's not an understatement, just favorite people up there. I was told that when I was a baby, I always had an affinity towards him. Even from a young age, I just trusted him. And I couldn't exactly tell you why I felt that way, because I was a baby, but I can give you some of my guesses why I felt that way. He just made me feel so safe. Throughout my entire life, if I was ever stressed or worried, I knew I could go to my grandpa and I would instantly feel comforted by his warmth and his gentleness. I felt comfortable approaching him with absolutely anything. Even if I was scared to, I did it, and all the fear went away. Because he listened and he understood me. And that's what made him so great to talk to. He would truly listen to what you say without judgment, and he would not impose any opinions on you. It was all about you. And some people may say that he was a good listener, maybe because he didn't really talk all that much. He wasn't a big talker, but I think it's because he just genuinely cared about what you had to say, and he cared about you. He makes people feel safe, like nothing's going to harm them. And like my uncle said, the most important thing to him was his family. And he wanted us all as safe as possible, and it showed. He was a family man, and he always put us before him. He was also a proud man. He was very proud of his family that he created with my grandma, proud of where he was from, proud of what he did and who he was. But he wasn't boastful. He was proud in the most humble way. He was satisfied with his life and what he did. I know this because one time we were talking and he told me that looking back on his life, he had no regrets, and he was happy. That was what he said. He said, "I'm happy." It's easy to talk about a great person, but it's hard to fully capture how great he is with just words. He was generous, selfless, independent, witty, and very funny. And no one ever made me feel as loved and supported as my grandpa did. And he never forgot to tell me how proud he was of me. When I was a baby, I must have known that he was going to be a very important person in my life. Now I'll miss him every day. I don't know if I'll ever get to see him again, this life or next. But I will do everything I can to keep making him proud.
Thank you. Our brother Roger has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. Let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves, that we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears. Read in sacred scripture. Come, you who are blessed by my Father, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal body. Grant that our brother Roger may sleep here in peace until you awaken him to glory. For you are the resurrection and the life. And then he will see you face to face. And in your life, he'll see life. And know the splendor of God. For you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Because God has chosen to call our brother from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth. We are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. For he is risen, firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise up his body on the last. So these prayers remind us that the cemetery where we're gathered right now is a sacred place. On the one hand, we can come here and remember our beloved dead. If you look around, you can tell the families come and decorate. They remember their loved ones. They honor them. But the cemetery is just a place of remembering and looking backwards.
Thank you.